Okay, so today is August 21st, the recap in Jtrader's small cap room. I'm a member, I have a small account, and this is my recap for today. So with JAGX today, we had the push pre-market up to 260s, and of course fell back down below J lines. And as we all were in the room early, we all had, were hoping, of course, to get a push. So as we all have our setups, this was my trade pre-market, where here it doesn't show the J lines, but I got in a little bit early, hoping to get push and volume up from J lines. So I got some entry here. I did sell into the push, and I tried to get more size back in here, which of course we didn't get the push we wanted. So I stopped out immediately here when we had so much selling going on. So just watching from the tape, we're getting a lot of sells. So I got out immediately and was hoping, of course, from the open, that we were going to get the push that we wanted. Of course, the line that we were all looking at, which was the line that I was looking at as well, was around the 180 line. So this is where I was hoping to get the push to size in. I did have some decent size available. I had 2,500 shares, well, decent size for myself anyway, to load. And unfortunately, that wasn't the case. When the market opened, this was my trade. So immediately when the market opened, the tape was really heavy, and there was not many bids coming in. So I took some starter position here, where I think I was in only 1/5 position, because I was really hoping to get more push. And as we were failing, I added another fifth, and I kept on adding and adding until finally we just kept on failing. This to me was a mistake. I mean, clearly the trend was bearish. There was no reason to cover here. Of course, we all have our faults and, you know, bad habits. So I didn't want to give back any. So I took a small cover here of 1/3 and then immediately added back into weakness. So these are sides that of myself that I need to fix, because I tend to always want to run after a trade, even though here I did have the right reaction on the stuff. But I did add it back here, and of course took my trades into the covers. My target was the 120. Unfortunately, I was not patient enough, because clearly it did reach exactly to 120, a little bit lower, and then push back, you know, and now is still in the area. So I'm pretty satisfied with my trade. Unfortunately, I did have 2,500 shares to trade off of. I barely used 1,100 shares in the position. So I do regret not loading up higher, but again, it's not an A+ scenario, because this was where I was meant to load up. So I was going to load 1,000 shares here and then hopefully add the rest here for the fade. So that did not happen. Now Jay did ask me to speak a little bit about the past 2 days, because in 3 days I basically grew my account 40%. Of course, I do have a small account, and yesterday, of course, we all were part of this amazing trade that we were in since pre-market. I was in here with relatively about 1,000 shares and made it all the way down. So I had close to $1,000 gain yesterday. The day before I had about a $600 gain. Today I'm a little bit over 200. So my account size is basically $3,000. Because in the past I've always traded with accounts where PDT is required. I started with TD Ameritrade. I did Lightspeed because of course I was a Ross Farmer client. And from there, I went to different other platforms. So having that 25K there definitely led me to load up on size. So I chose to go with a broker being international that allowed me to have smaller size. So a $3,000 account, which today is almost at $5,000. So I think it's good. I'm pretty happy with the progress. I do make it a rule that at the end of the week, Anything above 3,000, I take 50% out, because you have to pay yourself. You can't let the account keep growing and just seeing the gains on a screen. Those gains have to hit your bank account for you to feel that this is truly a business. This is truly something that could gain you good income. If you leave it on the screen, which I know how it felt for you staring at those profits and then now having to give up all of them back. So my recommendation to all beginner or intermediate traders is take 50% of your gains at the end of the week or the end of 2 weeks or a month, so that those gains can hit your account, you know, and then at least you can start feeling good about your gains and good about your progress. And you're going to want to, at least at the end of every week, be on a positive side. So even if it's $300, you take 150, leave 150. So the account can grow. And at the same time, your bank account could also get paid, because nothing is worse than being in that position where I've been in it, where I've been up amazingly and being stubborn, giving back all those gains and having to refund the account. I think that to me is worse than losing, having to refund the account. So overall, this was basically my only trade. I was watching LEDS, which I know many members in the room really did well. I was not part of that trade, which I do regret, because we did definitely get a nice fader once it broke J lines. And right where that arrow is the perfect entry off the rejection of J lines, push and fail, and then all the way down. So that's easily a good 40 cents gain. So that's it, guys. This is my first recap. Hopefully it wasn't all too bad. I didn't bore everyone too much. And wishing everyone the best. And hopefully we could do this more often and hear from other more experienced traders like Fateh, Janpek, Ork, and all the others. So guys, thank you, and see you in the room.